Hello, my name is Debbie Reynolds. They call me the Data Diva. Today I want to talk about post-quantum cryptography. So just bear with me. Quantum computing is the ability to use quantum physics in computing, and it will be what people consider the next age of computing because it can or it will revolutionize how people do computing in the future. Because of the power and also the ability to be able to solve real world problems much more rapidly. Also, cryptography, one form of cryptography that people know a lot about or have heard a lot about at least is encryption. So encryption is not the only type of cryptography out there to be able to protect data, but it's definitely one of the most popular ones that people talk about a lot. NIST, which is the National Institute of Standards and Technology, has been working on post-quantum cryptography for a number of years. And because of a lot of the advancements in big companies like IBM or Google working on this issue, they're seeing a lot of rapid advancements there and also trying to work on ways that they can implement quantum computing into different environments. The challenge with quantum computing as it relates to cryptography is that because quantum computing is so good at solving problems and being able to do it in a rapid manner, people are concerned that with quantum computing comes the challenge that a lot of the cryptography that's currently in use may be more easily broken. So NIST is really creating these standards so that in a post-quantum world that companies can figure out the best ways to implement cryptography and things like encryption in a way that quantum computing can't break it. So this is definitely still a work in progress, but it's definitely a big concern, especially as the technology and the law are going in separate directions as it relates to cryptography or encryption in general. So on the legal side, we have countries like the Five Eyes Alliance and different places around the world passing legislation where they want to create vulnerabilities or have companies help them in law enforcement investigations by weakening encryption. Probably not purposely, but the way that these laws are written and the way the technology is written is not something where you can weaken some of it without impacting all of it. And then on the technology side, we have all these big advancements that are happening in computing that would make the current cryptography much more weakened if we don't advance in that area. So this is going to be an area to be able to watch. Obviously, quantum computing isn't advanced enough that it is available commercially yet. But as the years pass and they go pretty quickly, we're going to be in this situation where quantum computing is being used. If we aren't updating the standards and updating the technology related to cryptography, that may pose a lot of risk to businesses and people as well as they're looking to secure their applications and their data going forward, especially communications that you don't want intercepted and communications that is really important that they remain secret and private, especially things like your personal communication, things like banking and a lot of the secure things that we do on the internet right now. So we'll be watching this trend as it goes along. I'm happy that NIST is working on this problem because this is something I've been thinking about for quite some time. So thank you.